One every 4 minutes. That's how many women will die from postpartum hemorrhage, and that's worldwide. In this month's health check, Serese Cole tells us what Fremont Health is doing to prevent it.
It's the end every expectant mother hopes for.
Everything went well. We were happy and content, and then it kind of changed really quickly.
2 hours after delivery, baby Blake was fine, but mom was not.
I'm having a little more bleeding than I have been the last couple hours. I'm like, I don't feel like this is right.
Darci King was onto something. She was losing too much blood.
If a mom starts to lose too much blood, they can drop their blood pressure. They can start to become dizzy and feel faint or like they're gonna pass out.
Postpartum hemorrhage is the leading cause of death for pregnant women. That's why it's now a priority at Fremont Health. When moms check in to labor and delivery here, they go through a postpartum hemorrhage risk assessment.
If they're in the high risk category, then the nurses alert the physician. And at that point, we have extra supplies and extra medications in the room.
And during delivery, nurses keep track of how much blood is lost.
It used to be that that was just something we kind of looked at and estimated. And now we're trying to be a little bit more quantitative about that. So we're actually measuring blood loss and weighing gauze and pads and things that we're using during delivery.
It's not unusual for a mother to lose up to 500 milliliters of blood during delivery. Darci, though, lost 1,200 as a nurse. She knew it was serious.
I have seen it and I've worked with it, and the outcomes aren't always good. I could have died, and I know that.
Darci was given medication to stop the bleeding, then a blood transfusion.
If the nurses weren't in there and paying attention, you know, it could have been really bad.
For this little guy, Darci is just thankful it wasn't. In Fremont, with photographer Adam Priester, Serese Cole, 6 News.
Darci was at risk because she had postpartum hemorrhage with her last delivery, but there are other factors to increase a mother's risk, like a long labor, having more than one baby, or if they are given medication during the labor process.